I hope all of you have a good holiday, safe holiday. We'd ask you to be careful in this heat that is so prevalent this time. But just now, if you would rise to your feet, we'll ask Mr. Black to lead us in our invocation, and Mr. Cotton, all in our pledge, Mr. Black.
Father, I ask you to be with us today as we go through this meeting. Give us guidance, Lord, and be with us. And Father, I ask that you be with our country. And Father, I ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Please place it up. Salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Be seated, please. Again, we appreciate your presence here this morning.
It always seems when I'm pro tem we have twice the normal agenda.
Well,
just a little bit, I guess.
We'll talk about that at But I thank you for your concern.
I don't know what it's implied.
At this time, the first item on our agenda is to approve our minutes from our last meeting. If there's any changes be made, I would solicit a motion. And an example, if not, do I hear a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
Your second?
Second.
Motion second. Any discussion? Means favor that I'm saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed, state your objection. Thank you. The first item on the agenda is our CDBG grant resolution. We have to have Mr. Blankenship from Tarkov here with us. Mr. Blankenship, could you come and give us a overview of the project that we're taking on, please?
By all means.
Thank you for your help during all of this and the prior projects that we've been successfully getting.
Well,
Mr. Blankenship has been with Tarkov, Top Alabama Regional Council of Governments for a long time and does a great job for us. We thank you for being here this morning.
Well, what we're talking about this morning is similar to the project that we submitted back in 2016, 2017. It will be a road paving project. County Commission, should you want to move forward with this, requesting $350,000 to be offset with approximately, Scott, what's the matching dollar amount on that?
$115,000.
To do road paving in the Kilpatrick community. Commissioner Westbrook, could you name off the county road names? You've got my cost list right there. We are looking at County Road 69, 113, 179, 370, 374, 467, and 479. Trying to pave the majority of those in entirety at this point. CDBG grant applications for the county fund are due July 22nd at 12 noon. Got approximately 2 weeks to get this one finished up. So this is one of the last things we have to do from a documentation standpoint to move forward with the application.
Thank you. And all of this is on schedule?
Yes, sir. Right. We are compiling all the low to moderate income survey that the county's been working on over the last couple weeks. Trying to get the grand tallies at this time.
Appreciate Mr. Westbrook. Work on this, Westbrook. I believe this is your area.
I also want to thank you, Mr. Blankenship, and also your staff. I'd like to commend our staff and a few volunteers that we had that assisted with gathering the information, providing, performing, conducting the surveys in the communities. It is an area that is in dire need of some assistance, and so thank you to everybody that was a part of this. And with that, I would make a motion to proceed with the resolution.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Can I ask a question? Just general information from the downtown Kilpatrick, north, south, east, or west. Where's the general vicinity? I'm familiar with the road, just not
pretty much the entirety of the community.
So so it's a nice property.
Any other question? We have a motion, is there a second?
Second.
Motion second, any discussion? Any favor, let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed, state your objection. Thank you, that record so stated. Thank you, Mr. Blankenship.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Engineer, Mr. Luke.
Good morning.
Good morning.
First item is our County Road 116 funding agreement. I have received the agreement from the state for the funding of the County Road 116 resurfacing project. This will be in District Four. This is some of our regular federal aid money that, that we typically use each year. This is the standard applicator, the standard agreement that we always execute with the state. It just lays out the funding and where it's coming from. So I would request that the commission pass a resolution agreeing to enter into this agreement and allowing Mr. Harcrow and Mr. Sharp to execute it.
Thank you, Mr. Pelosi. Good question, concerns that. Mr. Black, I believe this is your area.
Yes, sir, I appreciate the work that Mr. Luther's done, make a motion.
Thank you, sir. We have a proper motion, is there a second?
Second.
Motion second, any discussion? Any favor, let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed, state your objection. Go ahead with the council, chloride.
On June the 27th, we opened the annual bids for our liquid calcium chloride. We received two bids, one from Socalco and one from Southeastern Road Treatment. Southeastern Road Treatment was the low bidder on all of our items. And we're looking at about an 11% to 13% increase in these prices from, actually these prices, current prices are 2 years old. We typically, Southeastern's been good to extend their bids for 2 years. They've been doing that the last couple of rounds, but they were not able to do so this time for the final extension, so we did have to rebid it. So we're looking at a minor increase, over a 2 year period. So it'd be my recommendation that we award the contract to Southeastern Road Treatment for the next year.
Thank you, Mr. Blue. Gentlemen, you hear the recommendation, any questions?
Yes, one. Does Southeastern, did they provide a cost for not just tanker load, I mean rail car loads and tanker loads as well in case we have a cable bill?
Yes, we do. We don't do the rail cars anymore because of the issue of having somewhere to put the car.
If something were to.
Right, we have where they bring it and deliver it into our storage tank. A gallon price for that, a gallon price where they would come and distribute it onto the roadways for us.
In the event that in the next 2 years or so, not in the future, would we have the capability if a siding became available, which is a possibility, would we have the capability of rebidding out at that?
I think we could, I believe we could probably just have them provide us a quote for that mechanism. It's basically just another means of delivery. And I think we could just request a quote from them for that if that does happen.
Thank you.
Basically, we wouldn't have to read that this, just have a bid for that.
Like I said, I don't think we would necessarily have to bid it. I think we could just request a quote from them for that mechanism of delivery at the same way that we had done in the past.
Thank you. Any other questions?
Make motion we approve.
Have a proper motion, is there your second?
Second.
Motion second, any discussion? Any favor, let me know by saying aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed, state your objection. Thank you, that record so stated. Thank you, Mr. Blue. Sheriff's Office, personnel, Mr. Smith.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. I have resignations and new hires. For the resignations, it'd be Zach Davis and Mike Traylor.
That's both the resignations?
Yes, sir, that's both the resignations. And to replace those, I ask that we hire Riley Schrader to replace Zach Davis and Jonathan Whitmire to replace Mike Traylor.
Let's take them, the resignations.
I have a question.
Yes.
What was submitted says that Mr. Traylor retired. Is it retirement or resignation?
It's
is it a medical retirement or something?
Right now, we're not sure what it is, so we're just taking it as a resignation.
I know he's physically unable.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any any idea of the determination of what will occur on this, or at this point in the hands of?
At this point, it's in his hands. I've spoken with him, and he's working on retirement, but other than that, that's as far as I know.
Thank you.
This is for two resignations, is that correct? All right. You hear the recommendation from Mr. Smith, any other questions? If not, we hear a motion to honor the request.
I'll make a motion.
Do you hear a second?
Second.
Motion second, in discussion. Means if everybody don't say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed, state your objection. Thank you. Now, the hiring, would you name those again?
Yes, sir. We'd like to hire Riley Schrader to replace Zach Davis, and Jonathan Whitmire to replace Mike Trump.
All right, and you hear the recommendation, any questions concerning that?
Make a motion to approve.
Do you hear a second?
Second.
Motion second, in discussion. Means if everybody don't say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed, state your objection. Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you, sir. EMA recognition, Mr. Posey, if you'd come, please. I had this on here today because Mr. Clifton, Anthony Clifton, was chosen as EMA Director of the Year by the state. And they do this in quite a professional fashion. And we're honored that Mr. Clifton and the staff there have done such a good job. And he wasn't able to be here today. We're going to do it last time. He wasn't able to be here today, so due to some sickness in his family, but he'd been chosen as EMA Director of the Year, and we just wanted to make you aware of that, lest we let it slip by. But beyond that, Mr. Posey has been certified on a lot of things, even with Homeland Security. Michael, we appreciate your diligence, perseverance, and all of your work, but give us an overview of things that you have been certified on and how that our county employees can participate in that to ensure our safety program goes forward.
Yes, sir. As of the beginning of last year, I was kind of volunteered for the safety coordinator position, and through some help with some local jurisdictions, Mr. Stone with DeSoto Rescue and the DeKalb Ambulance Service has assisted me in being certified as an instructor for the American Health and Safety Institute to provide CPR, AED, automatic external defibrillator training, and first aid training to our county employees. We offered our first class yesterday. We had four attendees from the Council on Aging, and now we're hoping to have these on a quarterly basis. I'd like to have schedule one probably the first month of every quarter. That would be opened up to every employee in the county, and we would be able to provide that training at no cost to the employee. And so we will be sending out information to all the department heads in the future with those dates. And I would like to thank Mr. Westbrooks for allowing us to use the Fire Training Center yesterday, and hopefully in the future we'll continue to do the same. Mr. Westbrooks allowed us to use his equipment and his facility, and also a lot to thank of the leadership there at Fort Payne Fire for also allowing us that use of that facility. Also a lot to thank all each of you, Mr. Sharp, been working with him to try to get some ideas about how we can improve our program. Our program is in good condition. We just got our annual review from the County Risk Services, and they made a few recommendations, but nothing major stood out. And so I have already reached out to Mr. Sharp and the department heads to get information back on those reviews and those recommendations on how we're going to approach and to resolve any issues that we did have. Basically, it was mainly they provided us recommendations on providing cybersecurity, which is a big issue now because of all the technology issues. And just a couple of years ago, the city of Atlanta was locked up. Their information was
encrypted by a outside source, and it cost them millions of dollars to get their information back, and some of it they were able to get back. So that is a big issue on the radar of those who serve to protect us and help us protect ourselves.
Now, you being certified, are you certified with Homeland Security now?
I am not necessarily Homeland Security. I've got a security clearance with the Department of Homeland Security, provisional, and working on a additional security clearances with them as well.
Well, that's quite an accomplishment in itself to have that.
We'd like to say also we had some payoff for our training. Previously, a few months ago, Council on Aging, Ms. McKinney, she sent about 9 or 10 of her employees down to do a training with Mr. Westbrooks. Back in May, one of the Council on Aging drivers was on his route, and he. One of his passengers, they stopped at a restaurant or a store, and one of the passengers became choked. And the driver was able to perform a procedure, a Heimlich procedure, to get that person from being choked. And so he learned that in the training that he had taken through Scott and through the Fire Training Center. And so we're seeing payoff already of some of this training, because it's heart disease and choking and things like that are nothing to play with. It estimates recommendations from the Health Society is that within the first 10 minutes of somebody suffering a cardiac event, the chance of them surviving is very low. But with CPR and automatic external defibrillator, that extends that chances of survival until the emergency medical service can get their person to be transported to a hospital where they can receive extensive medical care to try to relieve any type of blockages that they have for a cardiac event.
Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to encourage, especially our employees that are out about in the county and everybody else that can, to schedule training for this, because it really provides us with a mechanism to promote our safety program, to save lives, maybe like it did with Council on Aging, and y'all did such a great job with it, and we appreciate that, appreciate your time and effort in becoming certified, and even as an instructor in some of these particular areas. I give you, other gentlemen, lead to ask any questions or make any comments that you'd like. Mr. Black?
Yes, you know, that would, you're talking about him being able to perform, maneuver. We hear this, but now, if it was on yourself, it would be very personal. That was, I think that if I'd been in that situation, I'd be very grateful for the preparation that you'd done. So, yes, thank you.
Some 8-plus years ago, this commission as a whole set out an intent to develop and personnel, training, equipment, so forth, the best EMA facility in the state. I think we're getting very close to being there now, but it doesn't mean more can't be done. And we're all committed to providing the resources that we possibly can, and allow you to take the training that's available to be the best, because it makes this life, the safety of our citizens in this whole area of the state, not just our county, better and safer too. And I think.
Thank you, Mr.
Brown.
Yes, sir. I want to thank you and let you know that I truly appreciate, as a citizen, all that you've accomplished, all of your dedication to what you do, and frankly, your brilliance. You just are so intelligent. And we appreciate you and your office and all of you. Thank you.
Sure.
Now, we've been talking about this for a while, starting this training, and I'm glad to get to it. And I
could save lives anywhere within our county departments, and I think it's very important.
Mr. Westbrook, you've been a vital part of this.
That's, I believe it's an important element of what the county can offer the public, as well as the employees of our commission. And I want to commend Mr. Posey and your staff and those that assist you with providing these services. And as you mentioned, my facility is open to you anytime that we can assist. Just reach out to us and let us know, because we're glad to be able to assist in offering these types of services as well. So proud to have you as a team member.
Thank you, Mr. Westbrook. Mr. Wood.
Mr. Posey, thank you so much for the update. Please express to Mr. Clifton how much we appreciate the job he's done, and congratulations for this position. That's an honor to have him represent DeKalb County in that role. And it's been said before many times by this commission, and Mr. Hargrove stresses it a lot, that we wouldn't change our EMA for any EMA in any state. We have the absolute best employees. Y'all can just go above and beyond what's expected of you. You mentioned, I don't know if everybody caught it while you were talking, but you mentioned that our system was in good shape, but that y'all were still looking for improvement, and that's what set y'all apart from other counties. That's all that set y'all apart from other operations just because it's sufficient or just because it's okay is not good enough. You're always looking to strive and improve on situations, and that is a great service to our county, to the citizens of our county, and I do appreciate these things, everything that y'all do. Thank you.
I'd like to extend that appreciation out to Mr. Clifton. He has been a vital part of not only the organization itself, but my career as well. Receiving that Pat Newhouser Award is an extensive, very honorable recognition that he received from the State Association of Emergency Management. That is that one award is chosen very, very carefully. They normally have several recommendations for that award, and so they take their time to make sure that they're choosing the right individual. So he should be very happy to receive that award. He deserves it.
Thank you. Mr. Posey, I don't know if we will leave out our other emergency personnel, like our sheriff's office, their representatives that are here today. We appreciate all that you do above and beyond the call of duty. You have a difficult job, and we recognize that. We thank you. Not only them, but our local law enforcement agencies, wherever they're from, we appreciate that so very much. Let me just give you one example, and then we can close our meeting. The other day, I was going about the daily activities, and some friends of mine in Mississippi were going on vacation in the mountains. And they got here, and gentleman was a paraplegic and had some kind of a health issue and was carried to the emergency room. Well, I was a friend of the family called me from South Mississippi and said, could I go by there? Well, I couldn't go by there at the time. So I contacted Mr. Posey, and Mr. Posey was good enough to go by and check on them at the emergency room, and even after they put the gentleman in intensive care, Mr. Posey went by there and gave them the information that if they needed anything, they called him. He would be right here close to the hospital. And Mr. Posey, those folks have contacted me again and asked me to extend their sincere appreciation for what you did that day. They got out of the hospital and went on their trip and came back by and called again to extend their appreciation. So that tells you what kind of didn't know Michael Posey from Adam's house cat, as the old saying is, but Mr. Posey went out there and investigated, yep. And I'm extending their appreciation. Thank you, Mr. Assistant. That concludes our agenda for the day. Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Without objection, so ordered. Thank you.